Greetings, this is another video review by the flashlight reviewer Selfbuilt. As usual, if you're watching these online, please make sure you have annotations turned on your YouTube player. I know that's not always possible if you've downloaded these videos, but I frequently update them with additional commentary you won't see if you're not watching them online with annotations turned on. Thanks. So what I have here in front of me is the new Atom light from Foursevens, in this case an aluminum build. They also offer it in titanium. This is a very compact little one-time CR123A light, or also RCR, 4.2 volt lithium ion max. It's very similar to the early Phoenix Preon P0. So I'll open this up here and sort of walk you through the features so you can see what's similar about the light. Let's open up the plastic first. As usual, you can see you get the somewhat typical Foursevens packaging. Here's the light, very compact, and it's aluminum form, very sort of minimum labels. You can see there's the emitter at the base of what is a very different type of reflector. Rather than being a shiny metal reflector, you can see this is a glow-in-the-dark plastic. It's a glow-in-the-dark impregnated plastic, I think, compound, which surrounds the emitter, which will give you a very nice and bright glow in the dark after it's been on. What it means, though, is there's no actual reflector, so you're just going to get really a pure floodlight coming right off the emitter. And I'll show you in a bit what kind of pattern that looks like. At the base of the light, you've got a magnet here, which is very strong. It'll attract, you know, metal quite well. If we have, like, for example, we'll just take a battery here, you can see it really holds. This means that you could mount it on a metal surface quite comfortably, and you could have the light, you know, projecting off, you know, horizontally if you like. So it's a very strong magnet. A few other features of the light, you can see there's a cutout there, although it's hard to see, for a wrist lanyard. You could thread it through that part. Again, it's a fairly fine cutout, so you wouldn't be able to put much there, but you can mount it on a keychain that way with a split ring or with a very simple little wrist lanyard. So we open it up. You'll see construction looks extremely similar to the P0. It's a similar kind of brushed aluminum finish. You can just see there's the contact point in the head. There's a small raised post in the tail cap. With the battery on the other side, and it's a very straightforward interface, which I might as well just show you with the battery. So here's a simple CR123A battery. You just put it in, screw the light closed, and as you tighten the light, it comes on and low. So you can see that, you know, it's a very, you know, even beam. You keep tightening it, it comes up to high. Now, of course, high is quite bright here on my camera. Foursevens rates this at 110, I think, on the high and 6 on the low. Fairly reasonably good estimates. I find they're often fairly conservative, so you'll see my numbers in the full review. But it's a good kind of two-stage light, and this mechanism makes a lot of sense to people. Start to tighten it for low, keep tightening it for high. And that's basically it. Very straightforward interface. Nothing to really kind of go wrong here. Very clear. Again, it's a remarkably even beam. There's really no hot spot at all. I mean, you're looking at the reflections on my desk here to get an idea. It's also not quite as green looking as it sort of shows up here in my office, although I do find a bit of a tint difference across the ends. So you can kind of see in that area there, there's a bit of a shading difference as you get to the periphery of the spill beam. It's a remarkably smooth beam, very slightly green tinted maybe on my sample, but I think part of that is the glow-in-the-dark feature, which as you can see is, you know, glowing fairly well. It's hard to tell here in my office, of course, because it's a bright day, but it works quite well, and it gives you quite a bit of glow for quite a bit of time afterwards on the light. That's it. Very straightforward. It'll also take an RCR cell, although I think with higher output. You'll get full numbers in my review. One comment I find, it's actually kind of hard to get the battery out once you put it in. The magnet is so strong it attracts it from the other end. So I find you have to kind of get a bit of a grip on the battery and just kind of pull past that resistance point to sort of break the magnetic seal. So it's a point to keep in mind. You may find it a bit hard to get your cells out. So just something to keep in the back of your head. But look at the rest of the packaging here. Let's see if we can get that all out. You'll see the light comes with a Foursevens branded, here in plastic, CR123A primary cell. You'll have the manual, which will walk you through all the features of the Atom light, how to use it, what kind of capacity and so on you can expect out of it. You also get a fairly decent quality wrist lanyard, as you'll see in a lot of Foursevens and Olight type lights, and of course your extra O-rings, as you'd expect. So all in all, a fairly nice little package, a straightforward, simple light. What's interesting about it too is they've designed a headlamp holder for it, That's basically very simply mounts in on the tail cap and has kind of an angle feature, so you can adjust an angle to light. So that's a nice option if you want to turn this into a headlamp, a very compact, lightweight headlamp. I don't have a copy of the headlamp attachment with me, so I can't describe how well it works, but I can see it can make a reasonably good floodlight for a headlamp in this kind of design, if you like that kind of feature. So, basic overview of the light. If you want to learn more about how it performs in comparison to other lights of its class, please see my full review at Candle Power Forums, where you'll find me in the review form under the username selfbuilt, or my personal website, flashlightreviews.ca. Thanks for your time. Hope you found that useful.